Toyota has dropped a bombshell that's sending shockwaves through the automotive world. We're going to take you diving into a vehicle that's not just redefining its category, but reshaping our very expectations of what a mini SUV should be. The Toyota Compact Cruiser, which defies expectations, is a 2021 preview of the automaker's battery electric future car designs. Japan will stop producing the 17-year-old gas-powered FJ Cruiser. Additionally, Toyota Japan filed an application to trademark Landhopper in Japan in mid-August. One of the pictures from Toyota's unveiling of the revamped Land Cruiser 2 days later shows the silhouette of what appears to be a significantly modified compact cruiser. Hence, this brings us to September, and two rumors originating from Japan indicate the manufacture of the smaller Land Cruiser could begin as early as next year in 2024. Imagine you were working on a new product for your business. However, at the final stage, you happen to know that your competitor too was working on a similar product. However, where things might have gone bad, you decided to launch your product as a twin of the competitor's product. Hence, the parties benefited. For the time being, let's just use the placeholder name Landhopper. According to Japanese rumors, it won't be limited to electric vehicles alone. Customers may be able to choose between gas and diesel engines, a hybrid powertrain, and eventually, an all-electric model that completes the circle with the 2021 compact cruiser concept. Additionally, the platform is purportedly the reason for the engine change. According to reports, Toyota mounted the Landhopper on a scaled-down version of the GAF body-on-frame chassis, which also underpins the new Lexus GX, the Sequoia SUV, the Tundra and Tacoma pickup trucks, and the 300 and 250 series Toyota Land Cruisers. However, for the time being, an all-electric drivetrain would have to make too many compromises due to the ladder frame chassis. The 1.8 and 2.0-liter four-cylinder gas engines from the Global Corolla Cross powertrain menu, the 2.5-liter four-cylinder hybrid from the RAV4, the turbocharged 2.8-liter diesel from the Hilux pickup, and the 2.7-liter naturally aspirated four-cylinder gas engine that is allegedly in development are the internal combustion engines that are allegedly in play. Apparently, the priority is to make the electric drivetrain viable in the Tacoma pickup for North America, and after completion, the unit will be modified and employed in the Landhopper, according to MagX, about an electric trim. The estimated measurements for the new mini SUV from Toyota are 74 inches high, 73 inches wide, and 171.3 inches long. Additionally, the Landhopper would be 2 inches wider, 10 inches taller, and 5 inches shorter than the 2023 Toyota Corolla Cross with the same footprint. In relation to a 4Runner, those measurements are roughly 20 inches smaller, 2 inches narrower, and 3 inches taller. The SUV will have a spare tire carrier, similar to the vehicle in the Land Cruiser presentation. Although Toyota unveiled the compact cruiser as an electric vehicle concept, it looks like the Japanese carmaker has had a change of heart and will continue to provide combustion engine alternatives for the production model, at least for the time being. Hence, the fans are anxious to learn more about Toyota's compact Land Cruiser, even if the exact features and specs have not yet been confirmed. It's also possible that this small SUV will make an unexpected appearance at the Japan Mobility Show in a different concept shape, until Toyota makes an official announcement at the event, which starts on October 26, we might have to wait. Reputable Japanese publications, such as Best Car and Magazine X, have reported that the tiny Toyota Land Cruiser may make its world debut as early as 2024. Furthermore, rumors indicate that the Toyota GAF chassis may serve as the basis for the little Land Cruiser. A similar platform creates the prospect that the upcoming Hilux and Fortuner may share similar architecture because of their modular design, specifically made for body-on-frame vehicles. Right now, crossovers and medium SUVs are highly sought-after vehicles, with the Toyota Highlander emerging as a particular favorite. With the introduction of the brand new Grand Highlander in its 2024 lineup, Toyota is prepared to step up its game. In order to provide greater comfort and space than the Highlander, the Grand Highlander will be an even larger SUV. Now, let's examine why the Toyota Grand Highlander 2024 is the best SUV to choose from. In addition to a new 2.4-liter four-cylinder hybrid max engine, the Grand Highlander features two of the Highlander's engines. The 2024 Grand Highlander is a powerful car because of its new engine, which generates 362 horsepower and 332 pound-foot of torque. Additionally, heated front seats, a wireless charging pad, and a 12.3-inch infotainment screen are standard on all model levels. The 2024 Grand Highlander is available in three distinct trim levels: XLE, Limited, and Platinum. Despite having three rows of seats, people won't feel cramped in this enormous SUV because there is still plenty of legroom and trunk space. Toyota Safety Sense 3.0 is standard on all 2024 models and offers a number of features including lane departure warning, pedestrian recognition, pre-collision protection, and more. Hence, to sum up, the 2024 Toyota Grand Highlander is prepared for any enjoyable family outing, whether it takes place on or off the road. With its steady and fuel-efficient manufacturing in the face of massive corporations like Ford and GM, Toyota had a modest beginning. However, Toyota did not become a household name in the auto business overnight. The business gradually increased its manufacturing standards and made advancements with every model. With over 9.5 million cars sold in 2020, Toyota overtook Volkswagen Group to become the world's most successful automaker. The global automotive giant commands a dominant market share in over 170 nations. There are many lessons to be learned from Toyota's amazing journey for those aiming for success in the business. Their strategy study provides a thorough overview of Toyota's gradual ascent to become a massive automobile company. What factors have made your product the top in your country? Might be making proper changes in the product by understanding the buyer persona or doing proper competitive analysis. However, what made Toyota successful? Modern Toyota production facilities may be found all around the world, and they gather and build cars for both local and foreign consumers. Moreover, the company's primary success element, along with lean manufacturing, is JIT production, which helps it keep its leading position in the global car industry. Additionally, in order to enhance its manufacturing and distribution methods for automobiles worldwide, Toyota launched its innovative International Multi-Purpose Vehicle Initiative. Hence, this is to satisfy the constantly expanding market demand in more than 142 nations globally. What lessons have you learned from Toyota's journey? How can it be implemented to make a successful product for your business? Do share your thoughts in the comments. And there you have it. The stunning revelation of Toyota's 2024 mini SUV has left the entire automotive world in absolute awe. Just when we thought the boundaries of innovation were being reached, Toyota pushed the envelope, shocking everyone with a blend of style, efficiency, and cutting-edge technology. Before we cruise to the end of this exhilarating journey, let's not forget, if you enjoyed riding shotgun on today's automotive adventure, make sure to hit that like button. Your support accelerates our passion and drives us to deliver the most electrifying content right here on your screen. So, as we park this episode, remember that the road ahead is filled with mystery, innovation, and excitement. Are you ready to be part of the journey where every turn is a discovery? Stay tuned, stay curious, and most importantly, keep driving forward with us. Until next time, keep your eyes on the horizon and your hands on the wheel.